when we think in the history of navigation, albatross is a very symbolic species. Some fishers use the seabird aggregation to try to find good fishing ground. They go for fish, they fish hake, fisher clean the hake, but after that, they throw the offal, like a liver, stomach, or gonads, on the sea. The seabird use this offal. Then it's like at the end of the day, also, they have like an ecological interaction, but also a cultural interaction. That is one of my main goals, to try to understand the relationship between seabird and fishers. Specifically, I like the idea to comprehend the reciprocity between fishers and biodiversity. The majority of fishers said, we are the last generation of hake fishers. With them could die also the cultural interaction, the connection with seabird, the history of the navigation.
Ya no existe más nosotros, con nosotros muere la pesca. Con nosotros muere la pesca artesanal.
Eso a mí me...
Nosotros, una vez que ya no estemos aquí, no va a haber más pescadores.
Y al final el oficio es el que se va a acabar.
Se pierde.
When the industrial operation go offshore, they catch a lot of fish. But also when they capture fish, they have bycatch. And some of the bycatch are seabird. Here, when we think an artisanal fishery in Patagonia, the fishing line goes very rapid to the bottom. Then the seabird can capture the hook. Then as the result of that, the mortality in artisanal fishery is low. It's important to understand the history of the hake fishery because it's disappearing. The fishing law, they try to support more industrial fishery, specifically more 7 or 6 families, which historically they have a lot of power across Chile.
No hay, nadie quiere ser pescador artesanal porque ya la pesca artesanal no da las garantías que da antes. Hoy día hay otras cosas que dan otras garantías y que le conviene a la juventud. Por ejemplo, tiene a la salmonera que nadie la quiere y yo tampoco la quiero. Sí. ¿Ya? Pero él da trabajo, les paga un buen sueldo.
Y ahora entonces los que tienen cuota venden a la...
Sí, le decimos sesiones de cuota.
Sesiones de cuota.
Sí.
Now the majority of the fishers sell the quota in industrial operation y today there are less and less number of fishers in Patagonia. For example, 15 years ago there were around 100 fishers, now there are 20.
Si la cuota la están sacando los industriales y venden 1200 toneladas al año, el barco puede sellar sus túneles con 40 toneladas. Para hacer esas 40 toneladas de pescado que al barco le sirve, tiene que sacar 100 toneladas, 60 las botas y 40 nomás procesan.
Mire, yo creo que las pesquerías de que se empiecen a recuperar es muy difícil, ¿eh? Porque volvamos atrás un ratito, cuando se empezó a trabajar en la merluza había una biomasa estimada así más o menos de 70.000 toneladas. Ya, y hoy día estamos bajo las 25.000. Entonces la pesquería está a punto de entrar a un colapso.
Es que el gobierno, los gobiernos son de poder, son todos de poder, todo pasa por el dinero. Es que vienen con políticas corruptas, viene gente del exterior, de otros países, de otro continente, de otras raíces, vienen y explotan los productos de este país, las riquezas de este país.
El hombre, el rey de la merluza del sur es don Aquilino López. Aquilino López mueve desde España toda la merluza de Chile. Él, en esos años y hasta el día de hoy, es el dueño de toda la merluza de Chile.
En coluido con los políticos de este país, con los grandes empresarios de este país, se llevan todos los productos de este país y los dejan a nosotros en la miseria.
I think it's really important for different parts of the world to learn from one another. The research questions I'm really interested in is how we can protect biodiversity while at the same time meeting the needs and desires of human communities. We're so concerned with economic growth above all else that it's hard to, with that mentality, to really affect change, because if you need more and more and more, you need to go fishing more, you need to have more industry, all of that is going to culminate in a lot of negative change on marine ecosystems and even coastal communities.
The hake fishery is not just money, it's not just economy. It's also part of our identity. When I say relationship, it's an ethical relationship, it's a cultural relationship, it's a social relationship with the biodiversity, with the local ecosystem. When you have a relationship, it's not just take money for that.
So marine protected areas might be one example of a possible solution. Now, when things go well, when they're designed well, and people are involved in their management and deciding where to place them, and when they're then managed well, they protect those species really well, and you can get benefits both for biodiversity and for people. These are not new ideas. People have managed their own marine environment for a really long time. And in many cases nowadays, we're re-looking at some of those solutions to see if we can merge them with with the problems that we have today. I always think that it's important to have at least some glimmer of hope, otherwise we wouldn't do what we do. It can be challenging to think about what the future is going to look like, especially with climate change. But I see such power in the drive of people to create change, and that's really what gives me the hope.